Dear students, next concept of projectile motion is explosion of a shell at highest point of its parabolic path. Here we know that explosion is due to internal forces. Explosion is due to internal forces. Suppose here we consider mass of shell is m. At highest point, it breaks into different fragments of different masses, m1, m2 and so on, mn. Okay. Now, the shell projected with velocity u by making an angle theta with horizontal, right? So shell is traveling in parabolic path like this, but unfortunately at highest point the shell breaks into different fragments. So to measure the velocities of the fragments, here we apply law of conservation of linear momentum. So according to law of conservation of linear momentum, if there is no external force, the total momentum of the system remains constant. So by conservation of linear momentum, initial momentum of the system before explosion. So here explosion takes place at highest point of the projectile. So at highest point, we know that the velocity of projectile is u cos theta only. U cos theta. So before explosion, the velocity of the shell is u cos theta at its highest point. So therefore, initial momentum of the system is given by m u cos theta I cap. Why? Because this is x-axis, it is y-axis. So along x-axis unit vector is i-cap, along y-axis unit vector is j-cap, right? Now, at this highest point, the projectile splits into different fragments of masses m1, m2 and so on, mn. Suppose if their velocities are vector v1, v2 and so on, vn, then final momentum of the system is given by m1 v1 plus m2 v2 plus and so on plus mn vn. So here there is no external force. So therefore, linear momentum is conserved. Therefore, by conservation of linear momentum, initial momentum before explosion is equal to final momentum after explosion. That is, m into u cos theta I cap is equal to m1 v1 plus m2 v2 plus and so on plus mn vn. Suppose, for example, if the shell splits into two fragments, two fragments, one of the fragment of mass M1 falls freely, then velocity of other fragment or other piece of mass M2 is. So this can be measured from this equation. So here, before explosion, momentum of the system at highest point is m u cos theta I cap. After explosion, it splits into two fragments only. So that's why here I write momentum of the system after collision is m1v1 plus m2v2. So here one of the fragment of mass m1 falls freely, so its velocity is zero. Finally, mu cos theta I cap is equal to m2v2. So by using this equation, we measure the velocity of other fragment m2. Okay, students. Thank you.